Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So in this video we will take heck reaction and we will take three questions from CSIR NET and GATE based on this reaction. So first we will try to understand what is heck reaction and how you will recognize it. So heck reaction is reaction between alkyl or aryl halides, or you can also have triflates, aryl or alkyl or aryl triflates. They will react with alkene. Alkene can be electron rich or electron poor. Any type of alkene can be used, and you will use a base and palladium complex as a catalyst. Then you will get, suppose this is your alkyl halide is suppose RX and alkene is suppose RCH double bond CH2. Then you will get RCH CHR R dash. So this will be the reaction. Triflate means you can have a substituent like this: triethyl amine and sodium alkoxides are used for this reaction. Okay, so these two bases are generally used. Aqueous Na2 CO3 can also be used. Then we will try to understand what is the reaction mechanism. Suppose we have the reaction between RX and this alkene. Again, I am writing this one. So what is the mechanism of this reaction? First step is this palladium complex will show oxidative addition reaction with this RX. So we, in the starting, we have this palladium complex. It will combine with RX by oxidative addition reaction to form N2PdRX. In next step, we are using this alkene. So this is your alkene coordination step, and it will coordinate like, then it will show migratory insertion reaction. Migratory insertion reaction, or you can also call it carbometallation. So in this reaction, we have this L2PD as it is. This X will remain as it is, and it will attach, suppose like this. Next step is the beta hydrogen elimination. A hydrogen from this position is removed. This bond will shift here, and it will move here, and you will get L2PD XH, and here we have this as product. And after reductive elimination, you will get your catalyst back. This HX is removed in presence of base, and you will get this complex. So this is very important to remember this mechanism, and there are very important point also which I want to discuss. So first point is the alkene can be rich, electron rich and poor. Okay, we know that. Suppose we have a alkene which is attached with electron withdrawing group. Suppose I have a alkene in which this group is electron withdrawing group. Okay, in that situation, your incoming alkyl from this halide or triflate will attach at this position. You will get this one after carbometallation. And if you have electron donating group, then your incoming R will attach here. So this reaction is highly regioselective reaction, and you will get only one isomer. Okay, so we will take some more example based on this, then it will be more clear to you. So here we have two examples. In this one, this is triflate, okay, and this is alkene. It is attached with electron withdrawing group. And in this one, this alkene is attached with this ether, which will provide electron. So this cyclohexene will attach at this position in this case. So you will get a product like this. So this amine is protected here by the CBZ group, otherwise it can show other type of organometallic reaction. So we will have this as a final product. In this case, this cyclohexene will attach at this carbon here. So we will get this one as our final product. This will be your product. There are certain important points also about the selection. But first we will take questions, then we will discuss them. So this question is from December 2018. This is our alkene. We will use this alkene. This is halide, iodide. So first step is the oxidative addition reaction of this halide with this palladium complex. So suppose our complex is like PdL2. Okay, so this will show oxidative addition reaction, means we will get this one after oxidative addition reaction. I can also write it like, for my simplicity, like this one. Okay, now this will participate in reaction with this alkene. So most important point to be remember is the first step is the coordination with alkene, then it will show migratory insertion reaction. So first it will show migratory insertion reaction, and in migratory insertion reaction, this aryl group will attach with the electron rich center of this alkene, because this oxygen will provide electron. Okay, so this carbon of this alkene is more electron rich as compared to this one. So aryl will attach with this one, and this palladium I2 will attach at this position. And one more important thing is these two will attach in syn fashion, means if it is above the plane, this will also be above the plane. This is very, very important point, that this addition is syn addition. Okay, so if it is above the plane, this will be above the plane. Next important point is, now we have a beta elimination reaction. So beta elimination means this is our alpha carbon. Okay, this one is beta, this is also beta. Here we have hydrogen which is below the plane, and at this carbon we can have hydrogen above the plane and one is below the plane. So we can remove hydrogen, any of these two hydrogens, and this one also. But always remember, this beta hydrogen elimination is also a syn elimination, means this complex and hydrogen should be in same plane. So this hydrogen is in same plane to this complex. This is below the plane, this one is also below the plane. So this hydrogen will be removed. Okay, when these two remove, you have a new double bond at this position. So you will get a product like this. This will be your correct answer, fourth, because here we have a double bond, new double bond, and this aryl group is attached at this position. So double bond is also present in this one, but this aryl group is attached here. So this is not your correct answer, this one is correct. So fourth will be your correct answer. One more important thing about this reaction is, you can have also a one possibility here. So suppose you have this reaction in the starting, this is new reaction. Okay, so suppose you have this reaction and same type of reagents are here, so what will be your final product? Okay, so again I will take this halide, and first I will form a oxidative addition reaction, and I am writing here AR for this one. So it will attach with this palladium complex and it will form this. Now this complex will show migratory insertion reaction with this alkene, and aryl will attach on the carbon near to this oxygen. So we will have a product like this, and also this addition is syn addition reaction as we have done here. So this, if this aryl group is above the plane, this palladium will also attach above the plane like this. Okay, next step is the beta elimination step. So here we have hydrogen which is below the plane, here we have, this is alpha carbon, and on this carbon we have one hydrogen above the plane and other one is below the plane. So one possibility is this complex with this hydrogen will be removed, beta elimination reaction, syn elimination. So we have a double bond at this position. But in this reaction, what will happen? It will show hydropalladation. Hydropalladation means we will have an intermediate like this. After this reaction, we will get, okay, it will attach like this. And then it will move to this carbon. And we will get this one. Now, it will show beta elimination reaction and it should be with syn hydrogen elimination. So, we have hydrogen at both position. Okay, one is above the plane, another one is below the plane. So, this palladium will be removed with this hydrogen. This hydrogen which is above the plane. Not with this one, because after removal of this hydrogen, we will get double bond at this position. Okay, and this will attach like this. You will have to attach this aryl, this whole group here. Then you will get the product like this. Why this alkene is more stable as compared to the this one? If we remove hydrogen from this position, we will get a double bond here. This one is more stable because it is in conjugation with this oxygen and it is more stable. So you will have to also check hydropalladation in addition to these all reaction. Sometimes in reaction, they will give you silver carbonate. If silver carbonate is given, there is no hydrogen palladation reaction. It will stop reaction at this stage. This reaction cannot be possible. So if silver carbonate is given, then hydropalladation will not occur. Next, we will take a question from GATE 19. Okay, so in this reaction, you have to find out this P and Q. So first step is the again, this oxidative addition reaction with this, and it will not show further hydropalladation because it has silver carbonate here. So when we will have oxidative addition reaction, we will get a product like this. Now this palladium will attach with this carbon or this one, but in all the option we have only 5 member ring, so it will directly attach with this one. This will attach at this position, and this palladium PDL2I will attach at this carbon. Okay, and this addition will be syn addition. So you will get an intermediate like this. Suppose it is attaching below the plane, it will also be below the plane PDL2I. Okay, then you can easily find out that it is a 5 membered ring. 1, this is 1, 2, 3, this carbon is 4th and this one is 5. Okay, so I can also write it like this one. And when I will rotate it, this group will go in this position. Okay, one more thing we have to show, we have to remove beta hydrogen also. So if this group will go below the plane, there is this group will remain above the plane. There is no other hydrogen here. Okay, hydrogen is only present on this carbon. One is above the plane and other one is below the plane. So this hydrogen will be removed with this one and we have a double bond at this position. So I will first number all the carbon. This is 6th, this is 7th, 8th, 9th. Then I can write it like this. So suppose this is my 1, 2, 3 carbon. Okay, and 4th one will be here, and 5th one, when I will rotate this ring, this 5th carbon which is attached with this 1st carbon will be here. Okay, and it is attached with this CN group, so I will write it like this. Then I will form a 6 member ring. So this 5th carbon is attached with this 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th. There is double bond. There should be a double bond between 6th and 7th carbon after beta hydrogen elimination, and this elimination should be syn elimination. So this hydrogen which is below the plane will be removed with this by PDL2I. So we have a double bond in between 6th and 7th carbon. So double bond should be here. So this should be our final product. So this option is in option A and B. Okay, here we have a double bond at this carbon and CN is attached here. Option A and C. Now comes to this reaction with lithium aluminium hydride. acetic anhydride and triethylamine. So we know that this reaction is the CN group is first changed into amine, and then this amine will attack on this acetic anhydride too. So this product option C should be a correct answer. Let's move to next question. This question is from June 2017. So this one is very easy now. And this silver carbonate is used here and it will stop reaction and it will not show further hydropalidation. So it will be stopped at first position. So first step is the oxidative addition reaction. So we will have this PDL2 and this I is attached here. So this is oxidative addition reaction. Next step will be the attack on alkene. So first step is oxidative addition reaction. This palladium will attach with this I and this. So you know that the attack should be syn. Means this alkyl group, this alkanyl group should be in same plane as that of this palladium complex. Okay. So if it is, suppose this will attack at this carbon because it is electron rich. It is attached with this methyl group. So it will attach at this carbon. Okay, so suppose it is attaching below the plane. I am not writing this part here right now, but it will attach like this. And this palladium PDL2 will also attach below the plane. This is syn addition reaction. And hydrogen attached on this carbon, if it is attached below the plane, then hydrogen will go above the plane like this. Okay, and this whole group is because below the plane, so this part of this 5-membered ring should also be below the plane. Now this methyl group will go above the plane. Okay, so this will be your intermediate A, in which these two, this palladium and this hydrogen is in opposite plane, because these two are attached in same plane, so these two should be in opposite plane. So this is in your option first and in option third. But this methyl group should also be above the plane because this part is in same plane to this palladium complex. So it is only in option one. Okay. Next thing is beta hydrogen elimination, and this elimination should also be syn elimination. So at this carbon, at this beta carbon, we don't have any hydrogen which is below the plane. It should be in same plane to this palladium complex. So this hydrogen is above the plane, so this beta elimination is not possible. On this carbon, we have two hydrogen. One is above the plane and other one is below the plane. So this hydrogen will be removed and we have final product like this, in which a double bond at this position. I can write simply it like this. This hydrogen is above the plane and this methyl group is also above the plane. Okay, so this will be your product B. So it is present in option A. So in option one, this is your correct answer. So this is all about Heck reaction. In next chapter, I will cover other reactions of this organometallic reactions.